As I was telling you previously, today we're going to cover today and next class we will be discussing a little bit of once again the pet preparation, but this time we're going to focus on reading, guys. So pay attention to the next exercise because it's going to be kind of a practice to introduce you to this topic. Okay, so here we have a small game. We're going to read 7 different short readings, and you're going to help me answering or choosing what does the reading talks about. Okay, so you're going to tell me what's the main idea of these short readings. Okay, we're going to make just 3 of the 7. So you can catch the idea of the exercise. Okay, let me make it bigger. Okay, so can you please help me reading the first paragraph? Let me see. Aldrich, can you help me reading this letter?
Read, teacher.
Just read.
Miriam, your group leader called the date of your London execution has been changed from Saturday to Sunday. Can you call her and tell her whether you still want to go?
Exactly. So, what do you think, guys, is the right answer of these 3? What is this email talking about? The group leader cannot go on the Sunday trip of Saturday. Maybe the trip to London will take place in a different day. Or maybe Miriam will not be able to visit London at the weekend. What do you think is the right answer? What is this email about? Who can tell me? Would it be A, B, or C? Is there any word that maybe you don't know the meaning?
Letter A, teacher.
Okay. The group leader cannot go on the trip of Saturday. Where can we see it? ¿Dónde podemos encontrar esta respuesta? ¿Dónde nos dice en el mail que el líder del grupo no puede ir al viaje?
Ahí dice que lo cambia de sábado a domingo.
Ok, pero ¿en qué parte nos está diciendo que no puede ir?
The London excursion has been changed from Saturday to Sunday. No?
Letter B, teacher.
Exactly, letter B. Here we have the trip to London will take place on a different day. It means that we are changing the dates, right? Aquí nos dice, el viaje a Londres va a llevarse a cabo en un día diferente. Es decir, que van a cambiar el día del viaje. Y aquí ustedes tienen la respuesta, ¿no? Cuando dice, it had been changed. No. Teníamos justo la parte que me leían, que ha sido cambiado del sábado al domingo. So, we need to be very careful with these small or short readings. Okay? Let's practice another one. Here we have another one. This is even shorter, más pequeño todavía. Can you help me reading, please, Grace?
The private rooms are open from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. to people with membership cards.
Exactly. Here we have an announce. Tenemos un anuncio en esta parte. ¿Qué significa o qué quiere decir este anuncio? A. You can get your membership cards from the private rooms between 10 a.m. and 2 p.m. Maybe number letter B. Only members can visit the private rooms from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. Or we have anyone can visit the private rooms from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. What would be the right answer?
Letter B.
Letter B, exactly. It says only members, right? And in the reading we have with membership cards. So they are related. Very good, thank you. Now, can you help me please, Juanito? Help me read in this, this chart. Activity school.
Activity school notice board. Placing you for next week's afternoon activities before Friday lunchtime. If you don't do this, we will select activities for you.
Mm-hmm, exactly. Here we have another announcement. Aquí hay otro anuncio. ¿Qué significa o qué quiere decir este anuncio? Let's see. We have three options. Option A. Won't be able to choose their afternoon activities next week. Will not be able to do afternoon activities next week. Or will have to work in the afternoons next week. What do you think is the meaning of this chart? What do you think? What would be the right option?
Letter A.
Okay, letter A could be. Won't be able to choose their activities, their afternoon activities next week. What do you think? Do you think it's true? Or why did you choose that, Jason?
Yes, I think it's true.
Ojo, que aquí dice, please sign up. No, por favor, inscríbase. Inscríbase a las clases o a las actividades de la siguiente semana antes de el almuerzo, ¿no? La hora de almuerzo del viernes. Si no se inscribe, nosotros elegiremos por usted. So, let's see if it's letter A. Anyone, another maybe answer?
Letter C.
Letter C could be a good option, yes. Ojo que aquí sí nos dan la opción de elegir, porque nos dice inscríbase hasta el viernes en la hora del almuerzo.
Yes, teacher, pero arriba dice students who don't sign up before Friday lunchtime. Entonces, o sea, me imagino que los que no hacen eso.
Exacto.
Entonces, dale después abajo.
Los que no hacen eso no van a poder elegir, ¿sí? Pero en cambio, si vemos, en este caso, no vamos, no, o la comprensión lectora que van a tener ustedes no va a ser siempre de encontrar la respuesta tal cual está en el texto. Muchas veces las respuestas están entre líneas, ¿sí? No las vemos tan claras. Pero en este caso, por ejemplo, no es 100% una ley que nadie va a elegir. ¿Sí? Aquí nos dice, won't be able to choose. No va a ser posible que elijan. Y en realidad sí nos están dando la opción de elegir hasta el viernes en la tarde, pero nos dan la opción de elegir. Ahora, en la opción B tenemos will not be able to do afternoon activities. No va a ser posible realizar las actividades en la tarde, ¿no? La siguiente semana. Pero si ustedes se dan cuenta, sea que ustedes elijan o no elijan, van a tener que hacer las actividades la siguiente semana. Eso es un hecho. ya sea que hayan elegido hasta el viernes o que no lo hayan hecho. That's why I think too that the right answer is letter C. Let's see if we are right. No. Yes, in this case, I don't know why Jason was right. Yes, they can't, they won't be able to choose, as you said. Let's do this one and then we're done because we have to practice something similar before I will explain you something else. But I don't know if you can read it because it's a little bit like soft, the color, but anyway, can you help me reading this one, please? Let me see. Alexis, can you help me reading this part?
Oops. If you take this journey regularly, you can save money with our super wet clean several ticket.
Uh-huh. So if you take this journey regularly, you can save money with our Super Weekly Saver ticket. So the meaning of journey, you know, it's like a travel. Maybe when you go to a specific place regularly, in this case, we have three options as well. Letter A. Cheaper tickets are available for people who travel often. Letter B, you need a special type of ticket if you travel regularly. And letter C, the Super Weekly Saver ticket can help all travelers to save money. What do you think is the right answer?
Letter C.
Letter C.
Letter C. Are you sure? Why do you think it's letter C? Let's see if you got letter C right. Why is it wrong, guys? Look at this. Here you have to all travelers. Oops, sorry. Let me just go back. Oh, I can't go back. In the last part, you had all travelers. Remember that in the previous reading, you had just if you take this journey regularly, solo los pasajeros que van regularmente o que ocupan ese trayecto regularmente pueden tener descuentos o pueden un poco ahorrar dinero comprando ese ticket especial. En la opción que ustedes eligieron, letter C, teníamos solo, como opción que todos podían ahorrar con ese ticket. Y en realidad solo podían hacerlo los que utilizaban esa ruta, no regularmente. Okay, guys. Thank you for helping me with this. Now you know how it's going to be kind of the reading section. Let me share with you some important information about this reading section of your PET exam. There have been a few changes since last year. So we have a few changes in this exam, and I will show you what is it about. Okay, in the reading section of the PET exam, you're going to have 60 minutes to answer six different parts, guys. You are going to have a longer time than in the speaking section, but you will also have more parts to complete. What do I mean with more parts? For example, today we're going to cover just part one, two, and three. In next week, we're going to cover the last three. It means that the reading section has six different parts that you must complete in this PET exam. the parts are different. All of them are about reading. Some of them are longer, some of them are shorter, okay? But here we have the first part, for example. In the first part, we're going to have something like we did just a few seconds ago. It means that you're going to have a multiple choice format for answering the reading. So you will have to choose between letter A, B, and C. And you're going to have 5 different short readings, okay? Very short readings like the ones we did just today. Okay, this is the part one. You're going to read small letters or maybe small announcements or maybe small instructions. And you will have to choose between 3 options. What is the reading about? What's the main point? What's the reading about? That would be part one. When we move to part two, we're going to find a very bigger reading. Don't get afraid because this is going to be much bigger. Okay, we'll start with some few small readings and then in part two, we move to a very big reading. Why is it big? Because you're going to read a lot of options in this part, okay? You're going to read a lot of options, but the format this time, it's not multiple choice, it's going to be matching. So you will have to match one column with the other, okay? And you're going to have 5 descriptions of people. Okay, 5 descriptions of people. And you will have 8 different options. Okay, 8 different options with readings that you will have to match with the people. Okay, we're going to see it so you won't get a little bit lost in this part. Once you see it, you're going to understand it better. I know you will. And after this point, we're moving again to part three. In this case, we're going to have, oh, I was forgetting. No, I told you, you have 5 descriptions to match. So here we continue with the number of questions, just 5. Okay, in part three, as I was telling you, we are coming back to the multiple choice format. It means that you will have this time 4 options, not three, just 4. 4 options to choose. Okay, we have this multiple choice format. You will have to choose between letter A, B, C, or D. Okay. And you are going to read a text. It's not going to be so long, okay? You're going to read the text and you will have to choose the right answer for the 5 questions you have according to the reading. These would be the 3 parts that we will be covering today, okay? And as I was telling you before, for this whole 6 parts, you're going to have 60 minutes. And as today, we're going to practice just the 3 first parts. Okay, we're going to practice the 3 first, but it's always a good idea that you write down what it's going to be or how it's going to be your reading section, because as I told you, this is a long or extended section. Okay, so you got some notion of how is it going to be. We have an idea, right? Ya tenemos una idea de cómo van a ser estas 3 primeras partes del reading. Now, Let me share with you some exercises so we can do it together. I'm going to ask you to help me reading a lot. Okay, so pay attention, guys. Les voy a compartir la primera parte, but I'm also going to ask you to help me reading as well, okay? Me van a ayudar leyendo también. Change this. Until this part, do you have any question about this reading section? ¿Alguna duda o pregunta sobre el reading, guys? Yes, no. If no, we can continue, okay? So, as I was telling you guys, here we have some small readings, very short readings, okay? So we're going to do almost the same as we did previously. You're going to read and you're going to help me with the right option, okay? So let me write the first one. Let's focus just in this one first. As I told you, in this part, we're going to have five short readings. Help me reading the first option right here, please, Kevin.
Okay, once opened, came on the closed part or refrigerator and used within 5 days.
Exactly. What do you think it is? ¿Qué tipo de lectura es esta? ¿Es un anuncio? ¿Es una carta? ¿Qué creen que es?
¿Un anuncio?
Uh-huh. Un anuncio, pero esto lo encontramos mucho detrás de los alimentos, ¿no? Que compran ustedes. Once open, keeping coldest part of refrigerator and use within 5 days. It's kind of an instruction, right? Son como instrucciones pequeñitas en este caso. What do you think is the right option for this reading? The product can last 5 days after opening. The product should be stored in a refrigerator immediately, or the product doesn't have to be kept cool. What do you think? What would you choose? Letter A, B, or C? Come on, guys, ¿de qué se trata la primera lectura corta? ¿Cuál de las tres opciones elegiría?
In my case, I think it's B.
Okay, letter B. The product should be stored in a refrigerator immediately. Este immediately nos quiere decir que apenas compremos el producto, vamos, llegamos y lo ponemos en la refrigeradora. Is it right? What do you think? Does anybody else has a different opinion? Okay, Brandon is telling me letter A. Why do you think it's letter A, Brandon? Can you tell me? Robert, why did you choose letter B?
Because it says once open it in the first part. So and it says the coldest part of the refrigerator.
Yes, it says the coldest part, right? Tenemos que debemos ubicarlo en la parte más fría del refrigerador. ¿Sí? Hasta aquí estamos bien. Hasta esta parte. The product should be stored in a refrigerator. Perfect. I agree. But this word immediately is not making so much sense. Mainly because we have once opened. Una vez abierto el producto. Este ya es un condicionante.
Letter A, teacher.
Ajá, exactly. Es por esa razón que la respuesta correcta sería letter A, letter A. Thank you, Brandon and Angie as well. Letter A, once open, una vez abierto el producto, mantenga en la parte más fría del refrigerador y use entre los 5 primeros días, ¿sí? Eso quiere decir que el producto va a durar 5 días después de que ya haya sido abierto y esté ubicado en el refrigerador. ¿Ok? So, letter A would be the right answer, as we can see. Let's continue with the next. We have number 2. Can you please help me reading this part, Erika Joanna, please?
We accept cash, tickets, and all major credit cards.
Mm-hmm, exactly. We accept cash, checks, and all major credit cards. Okay, let's see the 3 options we have. Option letter A, we have, we prefer to pay with a credit card or in cash. Letter B, we have, you must have a credit card and a cheque as well as cash. And letter C, you may pay with a credit card, cheque, or in cash. What would you choose? Can you write it on the chat? ¿Cuál sería la opción que ustedes elegirían? ¿Pueden escribir en el chat, por favor? Okay, I have letter C, 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 C. C, C, exactly. Why did you choose letter C? ¿Por qué la letra C? Y no la B, que están prácticamente iguales. Why letter C and not letter B? Look at this. This is the responsible for the answer. The modal verb may. ¿Sí? Acuérdense que este may o el might lo ocupamos para posibilidades, probabilidades. ¿Sí? En un futuro. ¿Sí? Es decir, usted puede pagar con tarjeta de crédito, con cheque o en efectivo. Tiene todas esas posibilidades. En cambio, el must es una obligación, ¿sí? Es decir, usted debe pagar con tarjeta de crédito y un cheque y también con efectivo, ¿sí? Entonces, este must nos da esa sensación de obligación que no es la que en realidad está comunicando esta lectura. So, the right answer in this case would be letter C. As everybody told us. Good job, guys. You did a great job this time. Let's see the next one. Vamos a la tercera. Here we have a kind of a short email, I think. So I'm going to ask this time to help me reading, please, Carlitos. Help me reading this short email.
Yes, Chair. To Maria from David, I know you asked me asked me to fix your laptop on Saturday, but I completely forgot about a meeting. I have to go to terrible, sorry.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. So here we have a short, a very short email. Let's see the options we have. Why is David apologizing to Maria? He cannot do the favor he had promised, is option letter A. Option letter B, we have, he hasn't had time to fix her laptop. And letter C, we have, he won't be able to go to the meeting with her. What do you think is the right option? Can you write it on the chat, guys? Letter A, B, or C? What do you think? Why is he, this guy David, apologizing to Maria? Okay, I have one B. B, okay. I have people with letter B. What about the rest? Are you sure it's letter B? Okay, we have an A. Let's see if you were right, guys. I'm going to choose letter B for all of the ones who wrote it. What do you think is wrong, this answer? ¿Por qué estará incorrecta esta respuesta? La que eligió la mayoría. He hasn't had time to fix her laptop. Anyone, what is the reason? Why is the reason you this answer or this letter B is wrong? Can you tell me, please, Janetcita, that you chose letter B? ¿Por qué creen que está mal entonces esta letra B? La opción B.
Yo me basé en el pasado, teacher, en el verbo que los dos estaban. Por eso elegí la B.
Ok. You need to pay attention in the context as well. ¿Sí? Mucho ojo con el contexto de lo que estamos diciendo. Aquí dice, I know you asked me to fix your laptop on Saturday. Y sé que me pediste que te dé arreglando tu computadora el sábado, pero me había olvidado completamente de una reunión que tengo que asistir. Mil disculpas, ¿no? I'm terribly sorry. In this case, he's not saying that he hasn't time to fix the laptop. Sí, aquí no nos está diciendo expresamente, ¿sabes qué? No tuve tiempo para arreglar tu computadora. Aquí más bien, David is apologizing for the favor he couldn't do. Sí, aquí en lugar de estar explicando que no tuvo tiempo, más bien está diciendo o está pidiendo disculpas por no haber podido hacer el favor, ¿no? Por no haber cumplido la promesa. Sí, sí, tal vez le prometió para el sábado, ¿sí? Que iba a estar lista, pues está de antemano pidiendo disculpas de que no va a poder arreglarla el sábado por la reunión. So, he cannot do the favor he had promised would be the right option. Thank you, Robert. Robert got an A in this reading. Thank you. Let's move to the fourth announcement. Can you please help me reading this one, Paola?
Okay.
Parking.
Okay, teacher. Parking, 2 hours maximum. 4 per hours, the value of a parking penalty, chair notice is 50.
Uh-huh. It's 50 pounds, exactly. So here we have an announcement of a parking place, right? Aquí tenemos el típico anuncio de parqueaderos. So can you guys tell me, what does this announcement is telling us? What is this announcement telling us? We have the first option. It costs at least 50 pounds to park here for 2 hours. Si la primera opción nos dice, cuesta 50 libras parquearse aquí por 2 horas. Letter B. There are no parking charges after 2 p.m. No hay ningún cargo, ¿sí? Después de las 2 de la tarde. Or you have to pay a fine if you park here for 3 hours. Tiene que pagar una multa si se parque aquí por 3 horas. What do you think that's the right option? Okay, I have a divided opinion. I have some C's and A, 2 A's, but most of you have a C. Exactly. It's not or it cannot be letter A, si no puede ser la letra A, because we have the cost per hour is 4 pounds. ¿Sí? En este parqueadero usted puede estar máximo 2 horas parqueado. Le cuesta 4 libras la hora, es decir, por las 2 horas, si ustedes se quedan las 2 horas, tendrán que cancelar 8 euros, no 50. Ojo que aquí dice at least, como mínimo. Es decir, no tiene nada que ver con el anuncio. ¿Sí? Y aquí tenemos algo muy importante, chicos. The value of parking penalty. ¿Sí? La penalidad. Es decir, la multa o el cargo adicional que ustedes van a tener que pagar si se pasan de esas horas son 50 libras. So, in this case, the ones who read letter C or who chose letter C were right. You have to pay a fine if you park here for 3 hours. Remember that this word means multa o tarifa extra, ¿no? Ese es el significado de esta palabra. Fin. Como pueden ver ustedes, a pesar de que son lecturas muy, muy cortitas, nos sirven para entender, para saber qué tan bien entienden ustedes si algo escrito. Es decir, cómo se desenvolverían ustedes en un país extranjero que tiene solo anuncios o instrucciones en inglés. ¿Van a hacer las cosas bien? ¿Van a hacer las cosas al revés? Eso es lo que nos permite evaluar esta parte. Ok. So, let's continue with the last one. Vamos al último reading cortito. Ok, let's move to the last one. Can you help me please reading this very short announcement, Erika Chuga?
Keep silent exams in progress.
Mm-hmm, exactly. Keep silence, exams in progress. So let's see what of these three options is the correct one. A, you mustn't speak during the examination. Letter B, please respect others and remain quiet during the examination. Or C, do not talk to the teacher. What do you think is the right one? A, B, or C? Okay, I have some B's, an A. An A, some B's, Okay, here the answer is divided between A and B. Here you have a clue. Aquí tienen una pista. Was it possible to contract this modal verb in a negative way? ¿Era posible tener una contracción de este verbo modal de forma negativa? ¿Existe este mustn't? Let's see, some of you chose letter A, which is, in fact, the right one. In this modal verb, as I was telling you, is the clue. Remember that I told you previously that must means an obligation. Sí, este must significa o nos da esa sensación de que es algo obligatorio, es algo mandatorio. So, you mustn't speak during the examination. No debe hablar durante el examen, ¿no? Y aquí nos dice, keep silence, manténgase en silencio. ¿Sí? Exams in progress. So, here you have, guys, how is it going to be your first part of the reading section? Something similar to this is going to be your first part of the reading. As these are very short readings, try to read them fast and try to read well the options you have so you can relate the readings with the answers. Si tratemos de en, como una pista podría ser, traten de leer el artículo bien, si es necesario léanse unas dos vecesitas y lean las opciones que tienen para que traten de elegir la respuesta correcta pronto. Como ustedes saben, esta parte no demora tanto, ¿no? Tenemos lecturas cortitas en lo que nos demora es en estar seguros de si es o no es la opción correcta. What about number two, guys? As I told you previously, number two was going to be a bigger or extended section. Si les decía que la parte dos es una parte extendida. ¿A qué me refería con extendida? Que ustedes tenían cinco personas, cinco descripciones de cinco personas diferentes. Okay, here we have, you can see five people. And the description is right after the picture, ¿sí? Tenemos la descripción de las personas justo después de cada imagen. Es decir, nosotros vamos a leer cómo son estas personas y de acuerdo a sus gustos vamos a elegir las opciones que tenemos en la siguiente columna, ¿sí? Here we have, look at this, we have 8 options. Tenemos 8 opciones de la A a la H para escoger cuál sería la perfecta para cada una de las personas. Okay. We're going to start with the options first, I think. Sí, para no estar dando la vuelta que primero leemos uno y después lo otro, vamos directamente a leer todas las opciones. Sí, todas las opciones que tenemos. Y después vamos yendo de persona en persona. Así ya con todo el abanico abierto de opciones podemos ir ubicando en dónde iría cada persona. Ok. So we're going to read 8 different options. And I'm going to ask some of you to help me reading. Let's start with option or letter A. Ok. Here we have letter A. Henry Drouet, The Portrait of a Woman. Okay, can you help me reading this part, please? Let me see. Help me reading this part, please, Tupac. Are you there, Tupac? Tupac is asleep, okay. It's going to help me reading this time. Please, Bibi, can you help me reading this letter A? Viviana, are you there?
Yes, teacher, good morning.
Hi, help me reading, please, letter A.
Yes, teacher. Henry Jowett, The Portrait of a Woman. The charming Evelyn Blanchett was a French woman who came to England in the 18th century and won the hearts of young men wherever she appeared. This enjoyable romance show us the elegant evening dresses, the wonderful rooms, and Evelyn's limits ace in an imaginary world full of gardens and palaces.
Exactly. Thank you. Thank you, Bibi. So here we're talking about the description of very different books, right? We're going to read the description of 8 different books and we will see which people correspond to each book. Let's continue with the next review of this book, okay? Let's continue with letter B. This case, I'm going to ask to Anderson, can you help me reading letter B, please? Patience Jones.
Okay, Patton Joyce, The English Corner, in a quiet English village by the sea. A young French widow gets a second chance at love. Annabel Hinger hasn't been back to the village of Aberton since she buried her husband 2 years ago. Now she returning with her 4-year-old daughter Alice.
Thank you. Thank you, Anderson. So, do you see maybe any new word in this paragraph? ¿Alguna palabra nueva? No? The good thing is that if you see a new word, maybe you can give it or make it sense, or guess the meaning by reading the whole phrase. Sí, a veces no sabemos el significado de todas las palabras de un párrafo, sí, pero va tomando un poco de sentido cuando leemos la frase completa. A veces no sabemos qué significa, pero tenemos ya una idea de lo que puede significar. Right, here we have the word widow, sí, que se refiere a una viuda. And we have some other details of this book. In this case, the name of the book is The English Corner. So let's continue with option C or option 3. Robin Green. Okay, can you help me reading, please, Paul? Robin Green.
Robin Green, Immigration. The dark future of Jupiter wants more than 90% of the world's population have yet killed by themselves and others who were listening to voice stirring their dreadful actions. Those who survived lie in a very hostile environment. Totality unexpected and then why so many twice and thrones.
Okay, so here we have a book of a future. I mean, this is a kind of a science fiction book, right? Because you are talking about the dark future in Jupiter. So this would be like the main idea of the third book. Let's move up then and let's move and read the next book. Okay, letter D. Can you help me reading letter D, please? Vane? Vane Lima, help me reading, please, and Kaufman.
Yes, teacher. This fabulous world book follows five American puppies, including narrator Chicken York, as they play and dance the day away using delightful, right and simple language. American author Anne Kaufman has created a fun, rhythmical story that is a joy to read and alluring to little ears.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. Here we have Baby Dance, right? This book is about American puppies. Y habla sobre cachorritos, ¿no? And this is, as here we have, it was, or it has created a fun, rhythmical story and is a joy to read and allure to little ears. Sí, es un gusto, una alegría para los más pequeños, ¿no? Dice para las pequeñas orejitas de la casa. Okay, let's move to the next option we have. We have option E, F, G, and H. Todavía nos faltan cuatro opciones más por leer. Vamos a ver what happens with this one, letter E. Bruce Nolan, Landia. Can you help me reading, please, Santi Mejia? Are you there, Santi? If not Santi Mejia, then can you help me, Santi Cedeño, please, reading letter E? Yes.
Okay. Bruce Nolan, Landia. Landia is a medieval park filled with pirate and warrior adventures and battles, and a group of boys trying to find their place in the world. The story focuses on a bunch of naughty boys as part of their coming of age. Must go through 6 months of physical training on land and sea to become warrior.
Mm-hmm, exactly. Thank you. So here we're talking about some pirates and warriors, right? Hablamos de piratas y de guerreros en este libro. Some battles and adventures, right? Hablamos de las aventuras de estos piratas y de las peleas que han tenido. Okay, let's move to the next one. Letter F, Automobile Association. Can you help me reading this part, please, Carlita? Letter F.
Automobile Association. Walls and Tours in United Kingdom. A free quite French edition with practical tips and advice to help you get the most out of your tribe to United Kingdom. It includes the detailed information on history, museums, galleries, churches, as well as some useful information about accommodation. There are suggested tour routes, maps, and directions.
Exactly. Thank you, Carlita. So here we have walks and tours in United Kingdom. This means, as the word said, a free guide. See, I don't know if you have been in different foreign countries, but especially on the metro section or maybe in the tour information or the touristic or specific touristic points, you have some free guides for tourists. So this free guide has very practical tips and advice for most of the people who's visiting United Kingdom, okay? So here we have a guide of a city. Let's move to the next one, letter G, Isaac Watson. Can you help me reading this part, please, Steffi? Steffi Calderon, can you help me reading letter G, please?
Yes, okay. Isaac Watson, the perfect storm, the silver white series from Señor George Pierce. It has been around since the late 60s and is known for its comprehensive coverage on a wide range of nature topics. The Perfect Storm is no exception. The book is well considered to be one of the leading guide books for the beginner and
exactly. So here we have an abbreviation that maybe it's not so common for you. When you see ST is because we want to say saint. See, it's like an abbreviation. Cuando vean esa palabrita ST, es la abreviación de santo. En este caso dice The Silver Guide Series from St. George Press. Sí, por la editorial sería, por la imprenta San Jorge. Sí, has been around since the late 60s. Es decir, que ha empezado desde los 60s, desde los finales, ¿no? Finales de los 60s. And it's known for its comprehensive coverage on a wide range of nature topics. The Perfect Storm is no exception. The book is widely considered to be one of the leading guidebooks for the beginning angler. Maybe here we have another word that maybe it's going to cause you a little bit of doubts. Puede ser que se encuentren con palabras como esta que les van a dar duda, ¿no? No van a estar seguros de lo que significa o de lo que quiere decir. Angler. Okay. Here we have una palabra que significa algo que tal vez no sabíamos y es un pescador, ¿no? An angler is una persona que le gusta pescar con caña. Okay. Let's see the last option we have right here. Vamos a la última opción que tenemos aquí. Finally, we are arriving to letter H. Estamos llegando ya a la parte final. Can you help me reading this part, please? Angie Gonzalez, The Princess by Doris McCartney.
The Princess. Open the wood. Ay, no puede bajar, yo no veo nada.
Okay, let me see. A ver, tengo más grande, dame un segundito. Oops, sorry. Que it's worse than I thought. Maybe.
Thank you, teacher.
Okay. Yes.
Yes. Open the book and you won't be disappointed. For one, follow it. It's a fascinating adventure with fantastical plates and the amazing creatures. All the be found used on the work of the relic. It's only you could squeeze from the elevator gate and the bottom on the garden to find it
exactly. Thank you, Angie. So here we have the book, The Princess. Look at the here we have a short description. Open the book and you won't be disappointed. For what follows, it's a fascinating adventure with fantastical places and amazing creatures, all to be found just at the verge of reality. If only you could squeeze through the lavender hedge at the bottom of the garden to find it. Okay, so here we have some of the books. We read different books, right? Leímos una variedad de libros, desde piratas hasta guías turísticas, etc., etc. So what are we going to do now, guys? We're going to read the description of these five people. Vamos a leer la descripción de estas cinco personas. Y de acuerdo a su personalidad, vamos a ver cuál de los libros es el que prefiere. Okay? So, can you help me reading, please? Christian, can you help me reading the first guy description, this one right here?
Okay. Jamie is looking for a book for his granddaughters for birthday present. Ideally, it should be about animals or elves and be a story he can read it to her many times.
Okay, thank you. So James is looking for a book for his granddaughter's birthday, and it has to be related with animals. Which one would you choose? ¿Cuál de todas las opciones escogerían? Which of these is a book that talks about animals? What is it? What do you think? A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. ¿Cuál de las opciones hablaba de animales? De ser libros infantiles.
D.
Exactly, letter D. We have puppies, right? This is our clue, our main clue. Here we include puppies and we have little ears. ¿Sí? Nos habla de las mascotas, de los cachorritos. Y también cuando escuchamos pequeñas orejitas es para niños, ¿no? Es un libro para niños. So that's right, guys. You chose the option D. Very good. This indeed is the right answer. Okay, let's continue with the next one. Let's continue with the next one. Let's see who's the next lady. Vamos a ver los gustos de la siguiente chica. Can you help me please reading this Susan's description? Monica Almeida, please help me reading Susan.
Okay, teacher. Susan is 21 and works from a multinational company. She likes romantic novels very much, especially if they contain description of fashionable clothes, magnificent houses and parties.
Exactly. Thank you. Which book would you recommend to Susan, guys? ¿Qué libro le recomendarían a Susan? Uno que hable de romance, que nos describa lugares bonitos, ¿sí? Casas magníficas y fiestas. Okay, Bibi saying letter A. Exactly, right? The portrait of a woman. Here we have is an enjoyable romance. And we also have that they show elegant dresses in gardens and palaces. So yes, 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 yes. It's letter A, definitely. So let me choose letter A in this one. Very good. You did a good job. Let's move to the next one, Andre. Let's see which book would Andre enjoy. Robert, can you help me reading this Andrea description?
Yeah. Andre is from Paris and he travels across England on business very often. He would like a book that offers accurate information as he sometimes has time for a little sightseeing between business meetings.
Exactly. Thank you, Robert. Here we have a very important word that maybe it's going to be a clue for the book you're going to choose. Here we have the word sightseeing. And he sometimes has time for a little sightseeing between business meetings. No se olviden que esta palabra que tenemos aquí, sightseeing, significa hacer turismo, ¿sí? Hacer turismo, es decir, visitar ciertos lugares turísticos. Okay, so Andre is from Paris, but he travels across England. And he would like a book that offers accurate information and a little of sightseeing. Which one would you choose? ¿Cuál le recomendarían a Andre? Okay, yes. Santi, Carlitos, and Carlita are telling me letter F would be a good option for him. Let's see if letter F matches. Yes, it definitely does. Ojo, que aquí nos dice, es una guía para el Reino Unido, ¿sí? Para Inglaterra. Y tiene una edición en francés. It has a French edition. Y aquí nos dice que nuestro querido amigo André is from Paris. So he must speak French, right? He must speak French. Okay, guys, let's continue with the next. We're moving to the four people. This time, the four person. This time we have Tina. Can you help me reading Tina's description, please, Asu?
Tina is a chemistry student, but she would like to read science fiction in her free time. She wants to buy a whale writing book with a surprise at the end.
Mm-hmm, exactly, thank you. So which book would you recommend to Tina? ¿Qué libro de ciencia ficción le recomendarían a Tina? Okay, Carlito says letter C, the one from the dark future. Okay, somebody else? Which book do you think? Which book would you recommend to Tina? Okay. Carlitos and Paola say letter C. Bibi also says letter C. Let's check. Exactly, guys. Here we have the justo en verdecito se van marcando las pistas, ¿no? Por las que podemos elegir este libro. First, we have it's the dark future. So, obviously, it's going to be science fiction. Sí, ya que nos habla de un futuro negro en Júpiter, estamos hablando sí o sí de ciencia ficción. Y luego, ella dice, with a surprise at the end. Un libro que le sorprenda el final, ¿no? Y aquí dice, totally unexpected ending. Un final totalmente inesperado. So that's why they match, right? Sí, esa es la razón principal por la que coinciden esas dos lecturas. Let's move to the last one. We have Peter's description right here. We have Peter's description. Can you help me reading this Peter's part, please? Let me see who hasn't read yet. Brandon, are you there? Can you help me reading these short lines, please? Maybe you have a problem with your microphone, Brandon. I can hear you. Don't worry. Don't worry, Brandon. Instead of Brandon, it's going to help me this time, please. Marjorie, I haven't heard you.
Peter wants to buy a book as a present for his friend Robin. Robin is keen on fishing and likes spending time in nature.
Mm-hmm, exactly. Thank you, Marjorie. So his friend Robin is keen on, es fanático de, ¿sí? Esa palabra, keen on, significa ser fanático o que le gusta hacer eso, ¿no? Es keen on fishing, fanático de la pesca y le gusta pasar tiempo en la naturaleza. Which book would you recommend? ¿Qué libro le recomendarían? Okay, Carlita and Jeanette are saying letter G. Yes, exactly. Remember that we had this new word right here, right? Angler. Esta palabrita angler ya nos daba mucha pista, ¿no? Estaba hablando de un pescador. So yes, letter G is definitely the right answer. Okay, guys. So now you know how part two of the reading section works. Right? Ya sabemos cómo funciona la parte 2 del reading. ¿Sí? Esta parte es un poco más larga, ¿sí? Pero mi recomendación es hacerla como lo acabamos de hacer. Es decir, lean todas las opciones primero y luego lean la descripción de las personas. Les va a ser mucho más fácil ir, pues, asignando, ¿no?, la respuesta correcta o uniendo de forma más fácil. That would be my recommendation, guys. Esa sería mi recomendación para la parte 2 del reading. Let's move to the part 3. As you saw, this is like the biggest part. Esta sería como la parte más grande. Si bien es cierto, tiene lecturas muy pequeñitas, ¿sí? El compendio de todas estas opciones pequeñitas hacen que sea extendida esta sección. Let's move to the next section, guys. We're moving to part 3 of this reading section. Here we're going to have a reading. The length of the reading is going to be more or less like the one we have right here. So it's not so big. It's like a common reading, okay? And you will have 5 questions according to the reading, okay? And you will have to choose between these 4 options, okay? This time we have 4 options, A, B, C, and D, okay? So let's read this short article. Maybe it's going to work better if I make it a little bit bigger. Yes, that's, I think, a normal size. Okay, so guys, I'm going to ask you again to help me reading. And let's see. Can you help me reading up to this point? Let me see. You're going to read up to this part so you won't get tired of reading. Can you help me reading this part, please, Wendy?
Yes, teacher. Notting Hill Carnival takes place in London every August bank holiday and is the most colorful and largest street event in the UK. The festival celebrates the traditions of the Afro-Caribbean community who emigrated to England from the West Indies in the 1915s, and they brought with them the Caribbean idea of the carnival with colorful costumes, processions, steel bands, and street dancing. Preparations for the carnival start many months in advance.
Exactly. Thank you, Wendy. So here we're talking about a carnival. Yes, this is the largest event, a street event in UK. So it's kind of a parade. It seems to be like a parade. Parece como un pregón, ¿no? It says that they got this idea from the Caribbean community. It means that maybe migrants came with this idea of this exotic event, okay? So now I'm going to ask, please, Grace, could you help me reading from this part of costumes up to this part of traffic, please?
Okay, sure. Customs need to be made flat wheel, ready for the carnival street procession. A street band practice traditional Caribbean music on instruments built from used old birds. Just before the festival, the streets are decorated with yellow, green, and red streamers, and playing devices are set in place to carry the rhythmic sounds over the road of the London traffic.
Mm-hmm, exactly. So here we're talking about the preparations, right? The costumes and also the music, right? Here they say steel bands practice traditional Caribbean music with instruments built from used oil barrels. Sí, es decir, que los instrumentos son hechos a base de barriles de aceite utilizados, ¿no? Reciclados en este caso. Aquí nos habla todo sobre el evento, ¿no? Just before the festival, the streets are decorated. Antes de que empiece el festival, pues se arreglan las calles. Aquí nos dice los colores, ¿no? Yellow, green, and red. And they use amplifying devices. Sí, equipos de amplificación, todo debe estar en su lugar, ¿no? Incluso para que se escuche, aunque haya tráfico. That's what they say. Okay, let's go to the final part. Please, can you help me reading the final part of this short article? Let's see. Who hasn't talked yet? Joanna Delgado. Está escondidita por ahí, Joanna. Help me reading, please, the next part. The carnival is celebrated.
Angie.
¿Cuál de esas alternativas sería correcta? A ver, sería mejor.
Hey, Joanna, you need to read.
Yeah. Le leo, ¿cierto?
De yes.
Yes. Yeah.
It's that part.
Yeah. And the caravan celebrates over 3 days and is full of music and colors. Processions of steel and brass band, float and dancing is colorful, construct made their way to the narrow London Street, watched a bit then of thousands of people. The streets are lined with stalls selling tropical fruit, such as fresh mangoes, watermelon and people apple, every young dance. You are all black and white, an event the police of duty that are in the phone for the 3 days in a wood, a Caribbean magic touch the trains of London.
Okay, thank you, Joanna. So here we have some more description of the carnival. Here they say the carnival is celebrated over 3 days. So this celebration takes 3 day time and it's full of music and color. Procession of steel and brass bands, floats and dancers in colorful costumes made their way through the narrow London streets. Watched by tens of thousands of people, the streets are lined with stalls selling tropical fruits such as fresh mangoes, watermelons, and pineapple. Everyone dances, young and old, black and white, and even the policemen on duty take part in the fun. ¿Sí? Aquí todos bailan. Blancos, negros, turistas, propios, ¿sí? Incluso dice los policías que están en servicio. The policemen on duty take part of in the fun. For these 3 days in August, a little Caribbean magic touches the street of London. ¿Sí? Es decir, que por estos 3 días, las calles de Londres se llenan de esa magia de ese swing caribeño. Okay, so now that we have read all about this Notting Hill Carnival, you are going to help me with the answers. This time we move to the questions, guys. Vamos a las preguntas. Now, can you help me writing the right option from A to D in the chat of the next question, guys? What is the writer's main aim in writing the text? ¿Cuál es el objetivo principal del escritor? ¿Sí? En este texto. Number one, to encourage people to celebrate the traditions of Black people. ¿Sí? Number two, to talk about problems with Afro-Caribbean community. Number three, to recommend people spend more time outdoors. And number four, to understand and describe the Notting Hill Carnival. What do you think is the main objective of the writer in this text? A, B, C, or D? Okay, I have some questions, some answers. Letter D, letter D, letter D. Okay, I have a bunch of letter Ds. Tengo un montón de letras D. Yes. Exactly. So here we have letter D as the option. Very good. That was the main objective for sure. Sí, ese era el objetivo principal del escritor. Let's move to number two. According to the passage, Notting Hill Carnival, sí, vamos a completar la siguiente frase. Notting Hill Carnival, number one, takes place every bank holiday. It's held annually in August. Is organized by the Bank of England or is held at the beginning of August. When is celebrated this Notting Hill Carnival? Can you remember? Let me come back so you can tell me if you remember. What would be the right option? A, B, C, or D? Okay, I have some answers. Letter B, letter B. Letter B. Okay. Letter B. Let's see if it's letter B. Okay, number two, you said letter B. It's held annually in August. Yes. Mm-hmm. Exactly. Ocurre todos los años en agosto. Very good, guys. Well done. So now we're going to move, or we're moving to question number three. Pay attention. In question number three, we have, let me move. Okay. During the Notting Hill Carnival, the participants in the carnival decorate the streets with colorful streamers. Number two, preparation starts early in the morning. Number three, music and colorful fill the streets of London. And number four, traffic is banned from the main shopping streets. Which one do you think is the right option? Okay, I have some C. Music and colorful fill the streets of London, okay? Okay, we're going to see if this is the right option. Vamos a ver si es la respuesta correcta. Exactly. Yes, we have correct. Takes place is full of music and colorful. Yes. There we have the answer. Let's move to number four, guys. Vamos a la número cuatro. The writer claims that, sorry. This one was the correct, yes. The writer claims that, ¿sí? El escritor, let me check the meaning of this one. Declara o afirma que, ¿sí? El escritor afirma que, number one, the carnival has been organized since at least 1950s. Number two, tens of thousands of people take part in the preparation of the carnival. Number three, dancers in the carnival wear special clothes. Number four, the dancers in the carnival are from the Black community. What do you think, guys? A, B, C, or D? Which one would you say? ¿Qué es lo que nos afirma el escritor? What do you think? Any idea? A, B, C, or D? Okay, I have some answers. Let me check. Okay, some of you say letter B, some others letter C. Tens of thousands of people take part in the preparations of the carnival. And the other option was dancers in the carnival wear special clothes. Which one do you think? Okay, I have more C's than B's. Let's see what of those two options is the right one. Vamos a ver. ¿Cuál es la opción correcta? Let's see, and let's check letter C. Yes, exactly. It was letter C because they say dancers in colorful clothes or costumes, right? ¿Por qué no era la parte B? Miren, por aquí teníamos thousands of... over here was, I just saw it. Lo acabé de ver, pero cuando se refiere a mucha gente, ¿no? En este caso que nos decía thousands of people, ¿sí? Thousands of people look the parade. Ellos solo miran, ¿no? El desfile, la procesión. No es que ellos son los que ayudan a, en realidad, como a prepararlo todo. I don't know where was it, but somewhere over here was the option. Sí, por ahí nos decía eso. Okay, so letter C was the correct one. And let's see the next and final question. And question number 5 we have. Although the carnival is a celebration of the traditions of Black British, sí, a pesar de que el carnaval es una celebración de la tradición, de las tradiciones de la gente negra de Gran Bretaña, tenemos 4 options. Option number 1, everyone seems to participate in it. Letter B, only Caribbean people take part in it. Letter C, it is gaining in popularity among the white in recent years. And number 4, people from all over the world come and watch it. What do you think is the right answer? A, B, C, or D? Okay, I have one B. A, okay, exactly, I have some A's. Everyone seems to participate in it. Yes, that's right. Even the policemen, right? They say even the policemen who are on duty, they take part in the fun. So this was the right option. Okay, guys, great, good job. Now you know how part 3 of the reading section works. Don't forget, guys, and as long as I see, you got or you did a great job in part number 2 and in part number 3. Maybe the part that is giving us some headache could be number 1, even though it's the shortest part. ¿Sí? A pesar de que en la parte 1 tiende a ser la parte como que más cortita, a veces puede ser la que más dolor de cabeza nos va a dar. ¿Por qué? Porque textos muy cortos pueden tener la tendencia a ser mal interpretados. Ok, we're going to have just a short practice. We're going to make 3 more of part 1. Vamos a hacer 3 3 anuncios de la parte 1, ¿sí? Acuérdense que en la parte 1 teníamos esas lecturas chiquititas, ¿sí? Y tenemos que escoger qué es lo que nos dicen, ¿no? De qué se tratan estas lecturas pequeñas. So, we're going to make just 3 of them. and then we are done. ¿Sí? Hacemos solo tres como para ya terminar la práctica y luego vamos al classwork del día de hoy. Okay, guys, so can you help me reading this very short announcement, please, Marlon? Are you there, Marlon?
Okay, teacher. If you take this journey regularly, you can save money while our super weekly save ticket.
Mm-hmm. This is something that we already saw, right? Acabamos de ver este. Can you remember what was the right option? One, two, or three? A, B, or C?
Three.
Mm-hmm. Okay, cheaper tickets are available for people who travel often. Okay, are you sure? Okay, exactly, yes. You remember the answer. ¿Se acordaron de la respuesta? Vamos a la siguiente, al siguiente mensaje. Here we have a new one. Aquí ya tenemos un mensaje nuevo. Help me reading this new message, please. Help me reading, please. Santi Cedeño, help me reading this one, please.
Tom, I'm going to be late. Don't wait for me at the bar. I go straight to the restaurant and see you there. Yes.
Exactly. Okay. So, what does it say? ¿Qué nos dicen aquí? Number one, Tom should go to a restaurant without Jess. Number two, Jess can go to the restaurant. She will meet Tom at the bar. And number three, Jess will meet Tom at the bar. Which one is the right answer? Okay, we have letter A. Tom should go to the restaurant without Jess. Okay, letter A. I have another letter A. That's right. Ojo, no, aquí nos dice, I'll go straight to the restaurant. Voy a ir directamente al restaurante. Nos vemos ahí. No? Okay. No me esperes en el bar. Vaya directo al restaurante. Letter A was the correct one. Thank you. Can you help me reading this one, please, Kevin? Special offer.
Okay, special offer. If you use the swimming pool 10 times in 1 month, you can attend one water fitness class free of charge.
Exactly. So let's see which one is the right option right here. Number one says, the water fitness classes are free to people who swim 10 times in a month. Number two, the swimming pool is free to people who go to the water fitness classes. And number three, this month, you can go to water fitness classes and use the swimming pool 10 times without paying. Which option do you think is the right? A, B, or C?
Letter A.
Letter A. Mm-hmm. Letter A. Santi and Carlita also agree with letter A. Brandon as well. Okay, yes, it's letter A. Sí, a veces nos están básicamente diciendo lo mismo, pero utilizan palabras sinónimas. Sí, en este caso, miren, tenemos free of charge. Sí, este Libre de recargo significa gratis, ¿no es cierto? It's free. It's free. Es gratis. So here we have the water fitness class are free to people who swim 10 times in the month. ¿Sí? Para las, todas las personas que vayan al menos 10 veces al mes a la piscina, tienen gratis su clase de fitness, bla, bla, bla. Okay, guys. As I told you, we were going to practice just three. And we're done with this part of reading. Thank you guys for your kind attention. Now, what are we going to do? ¿Qué vamos a hacer ahora, chicos? Let me explain you a little bit about your classwork, today's classwork. As you see, we have covered these three parts of the reading section. Now it's your turn to practice. ¿Sí? Van a tener ahora ustedes su turno para practicar. Y como la parte de reading, si ustedes se acuerdan, tiene un total, un tiempo total de 60 minutos. ¿Sí? Toda la prueba, es decir, las seis partes, ustedes deben completarla en 60 minutos. El día de hoy ustedes van a realizar su classwork, es decir, van a completar una live worksheet as always. ¿Sí? Van a completar una hoja, pero esta hoja ustedes la van a completar únicamente de las tres primeras partes que son las que hemos repasado. ¿Ok? So, you will have to complete these three parts. And as we're going to do just the half of the parts of this reading section, you're going to have the half of the time to complete it. Okay? Try to push yourselves. ¿Sí? Traten de un poco presionarse, chicos. Vamos a tratar de cumplir esta tarea en 30 minutos únicamente. ¿Sí? Tomando en cuenta que estamos haciendo la mitad de las partes. Por lo tanto, ocupamos la mitad del tiempo, ¿sí? Here I have, you can see on your screens, what is it going to be about? ¿Tienen de qué se trata la primera parte? Miren, tenemos los cinco anuncios pequeñitos, como los que acabamos de ver, y tienen las diferentes opciones, ¿no? A, B y C. Vayan eligiendo la correcta, la que ustedes crean que sea correcta, A, B o C, ¿sí? Escríbanla en mayúsculas de preferencia para que no tengan ningún problema. Then you have part two. Luego tenemos la parte dos. Recuerden que teníamos a cinco personas con sus gustos y ocho opciones para escoger, ¿ok? Y ustedes van a poner cuál es la opción que corresponde junto a cada persona. Tal vez es la A, tal vez es la H, tal vez es la F. The one that you think is the right one. Okay. And finally, we move to part three. Finalmente terminamos con la parte tres. Es decir, leemos este pequeño artículo y ustedes van a elegir la opción correcta. Puede ser A, puede ser B, puede ser C, o puede ser D. Okay? This would be your classwork for today, guys. Let me share with you the link. There you go. Can you see the link on your chat box, guys?
Let's just... Yes, teacher.
Okay. Okay, guys. So... Try to start. Vamos a empezar desde 10 para las 9, es decir, ya en un minutito. Y vamos a tener 30 minutos para completar. Tomémonos el tiempo para que hagamos como un simulacro ya del día del examen. Y no les coja de nuevas el tiempo. Ok. No se olviden que van a enviar las respuestas del profesor y van a subir la evidencia. There you go, guys. Now you can start. You have 30 minutes to complete. Tenemos 30 minutos para completar. Good luck, everyone. Buena suerte a todos, chicos. The alarm is set. Está puesta ya la alarma. Tienen ustedes 30 minutos para completar. Any question about today's topic? Is it kind of hard? Is it difficult? Is it easy? ¿Cómo se les hizo el día de hoy? ¿Fácil? ¿Difícil? Tell me, guys. Any question, maybe, Grace? Any question? Leslie, doubts, maybe questions, Juanito.
Teacher.
Yes, tell me.
Yo siempre he tenido esta duda, ¿hay que subir solo la nota o todo el trabajo, las capturas?
No es necesario que me suban todo el trabajo porque cuando ustedes me envían a mí el trabajo al mail, yo tengo completo su trabajo. Sí, sí. Suben la parte de la nota, no hay problema. Es únicamente como evidencia nada más.
Ok, thank you, teacher.
Good to know. Thank you. Any other question, guys? ¿Alguna otra duda o pregunta? Carlita.
Yo una pregunta.
Sure.
Bueno, una sugerencia. No, que no sea una sugerencia. Eso para practicar más el listening, que se me complica bastante a mí.
Okay.
¿En qué plataforma sería?
A ver, les voy a enviar un link a ambos chats. Sí, el chat de Zoom y el chat también de WhatsApp, del grupo de WhatsApp, para que puedan ustedes practicar. Van a encontrar un montón de tips. Y es que ustedes buscan videos de, sobre todo de, ¿cómo se dice esto? El PET exam, van a encontrar un montón. Algo que siempre les dicen es no se presenten si no saben los verbos en pasado y en pasado participio. Eso sí es fundamental. Eso es oro. Si ustedes saben la lista de los verbos irregulares en pasado simple y en pasado participio, es una gran ayuda, es una gran herramienta. Les voy a compartir, déjame ver, aquí tengo algunos una práctica de listening. Aquí está, let me see, Pet. Pueden incluso ustedes ingresar a la plataforma de Cambridge y ver los test de años anteriores, ¿no? Siempre publican los test de años pasados porque ellos nunca toman lo mismo. Cada año van cambiando. En esta página que les envié ahorita al chat de Zoom, pueden encontrar algunos ejercicios prácticos. Mucho ojo que ustedes puede ser que todavía se encuentren con ejercicios de años pasados, porque en el 2020 apenas hicieron una reforma. Entonces hay nuevos ejercicios. No todos son los ejercicios que ustedes van a encontrarse en algunas páginas. Es por eso que si ustedes van a buscar, tal vez, pueden poner lo siguiente. Sample exams 2020. Sí, si es que buscan con ese título que les mandé al chat, es muy probable que se encuentren con los nuevos tests, es decir, con los tests actualizados, los exámenes actualizados. Sí, fresquitos los ejercicios. Por eso la parte de reading me costó un poco más modificar. Porque sí hay ejercicios nuevos. Algunos se han quitado. Por ejemplo, en el reading ustedes ya no tienen true and false. Sí, verdadero y falso. Ese se quitó de la parte de reading. Y más bien añadieron un texto vacío con espacios en blanco en los que ustedes deben llenar con las palabras que creen que son las adecuadas. Entonces, han ido modificando un poco los tests, pero pueden practicar, si es cuestión de practicar sobre todo listening, puedes hacerlo en esa página. También hay otros videos, denme un segundito, les les busco. ¿Qué les pueden ser a ustedes de ayuda? Yo les decía en la página de Cambridge también pueden encontrar los exámenes de años pasados. Sí, les indico, les envío la página de Cambridge también. Y en YouTube también hay 1,000,000 de videos que les pueden ser de utilidad. A ver, en esta pueden descargarse las control C y control V. Los exámenes anteriores, incluso de listening, les comparto la pantalla para que ustedes sepan de lo que estoy hablando. A ver, entonces el primer link que les envié fue esta página que dice Exam English. Aquí tienen el preliminary, que es el PET, el B1. Y cuando ustedes hacen clic ahí, les van a salir todas estas opciones. Aquí ustedes tienen tiempo extendido. Sí, tiempo extendido. Generalmente el tiempo extendido se da cuando son exámenes presenciales. Pero al ser exámenes en línea, se reduce el tiempo de realización de las partes, ¿no? Por ejemplo, aquí el reading tienen 45 minutos. El reading se le ha adaptado para que ustedes lo hagan en 30 minutos únicamente. 30 minutos más o menos la parte como hicimos hoy, ¿no? De la 1 a la 3. De ahí las 6 partes está adaptado para que dure 60 minutos en realidad. Miren, aquí tienen la parte de reading, writing, listening y speaking. Si quieren practicar listening, le dan clic a listening. Y tienen las partes, ¿no? Parte 1, parte 2, parte 3 y parte 4 que fueron las que vimos. Le dan clic a la parte que quieran ustedes repasar y van a tener ahí pues algunos audios de práctica. Eso sería en cuanto a el primer link que les envié. Si ustedes quieren descargarse de la página de Cambridge, que les envié también el link, miren, se les va a presentar esta página. Que dice B1 Preliminary for Schools Preparation, que es del PET. Sí, aquí tenemos Free Paper-Based Sample Test. Sí, este es gratuito. Dice, es una prueba de ejemplo y pueden descargarse ustedes aquí. Si quieren como practicar, ¿no? De forma manual. Pero si quieren hacer ustedes un poco de práctica en la computadora o en el teléfono, pueden ir a esta parte que dice Free Computer Based Sample Test. Es decir, se les va a abrir aquí en la computadora. Lo que van a hacer aquí es, en este caso, abrir la parte que ustedes deseen practicar, ya sea reading, writing o listening. ¿Sí? Primero abrimos el test y si ustedes quieren chequear las respuestas, miren, las tienen aquí en la parte de abajo como Answer Key. Si le damos clic a Listening, se nos va a abrir la página que nos redirecciona a los ejercicios de Listening, ¿no? Para que ustedes puedan practicar. Esas serían más o menos algunas de las páginas que pueden ustedes utilizar como para practicar el Listening en este caso. Let me see. I have it over here. Acá tienen un par de ejemplos de cómo se da el speaking también. Y una lista de vocabulario que es imprescindible para ustedes ya en un nivel B1. Incluso hay videos. La próxima clase les indico un video con un poco de contenido de vocabulario que es necesario que toda persona de B1 deba o sepa utilizar, ¿sí? Por ejemplo, si en su speaking ustedes utilizan palabras como perhaps, however, nevertheless, ese tipo de palabras les dan muchísimos puntos y pueden hacer que ustedes terminen muy bien su speaking. Esos son como que un par de truquitos que pueden utilizar a la hora de su test. No sé si está claro, si les es de ayuda. Tal vez.
Yes, teacher.
Yes, teacher.
Yes, tell me.
Links al WhatsApp.
Sí, ya les envío al WhatsApp.
Gracias, teacher.
Ya les envío. Tendría que enviarles este. A ver, para que ustedes elijan más bien desde la primera, desde aquí. A ver, sample tests. Deben irles llegando ya los links. Denme un segundito que se conecte el WhatsApp. Y este otro también. Está, aquí está la página de Cambridge. Si en algún caso no se les abre, puede ser por alguna configuración del buscador. Pueden intentar abriendo desde otro buscador. Y denme un segundito, ya les envío también la otra. Listo, chicos. Tienen también en su chat de Zoom. Do you have any other question, guys? La siguiente clase, vamos a ver las tres últimas partes del reading, es decir, reading part 4, 5, and 6. Y eso quiere decir que ustedes también van a completar o van a tener tiempo para hacer una parte del reading completa. ¿Sí? Esa parte de reading completa de la 1 a la 6 nos va a permitir a nosotros ver cómo estarían en la sección de reading. ¿Sí? Y esa, la nota que saque en la siguiente clase, transformada a 2.5, ya nos da un poco de conocimiento de cuánto más o menos podrían ustedes estar sacando en esta sección en el examen, ¿no? De suficiencia.